All right, here we are.
Dire team
back at it again.
Earth spirit.
With the white Vans. Don't worry, I don't wear white Vans. I actually wear some other shoes, but we're back at it again with Premier League for joinDOTA Season 13 EU. That's right. We're getting all football on ya. We've got Premier League. Soon we'll have Championship League. I made this joke last game. League 1, League 2, League 3. And if you're lucky,
5 seconds remaining.
We'll give you a little bit of that J League, that Japanese League 1 with the Kawasaki Frontale. But let's get into the draft. Mega-Lada, they go for the Axe and the Warlock this time around. Switch it up a little bit. And something to note, Peksu not going to be in this game, too. It's Insania. With the now drafting and back in the lineup. So we'll see how Alliance plays it with someone different here. And let's take a look. Beastmaster, Wisp, and Nightstalker banned out by Mega-Lada. Chen, Clockwork, Tusk by Alliance. Lashrak, Earth Spirit from Alliance. I think that's a Tega Earth Spirit, which you guys are in for a treat, by the way.
Radiant team,
Dire
ban.
Team ban.
So Slark banned out, Sand King banned out. So we'll see where the Lashrak is, because this could definitely be a position 5 Lashrak.
Remaining.
We'll see if it does end up in the core role. Maybe it ends up in that 5. I mean, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world with the Earth Spirit to be in that 5 position. I think it could be pretty aggressive, which is what we saw Alliance kind of playing in the last game. They played team fight, but aggressive. Especially once they had
Radiant team
Beastmaster and ready to go with the Blink Dagger, Lycan with a little bit of farm, and Mickey, of course, finding the boots to travel. And then the Yules, you know, he was really able to make something happen early on at that point. So we'll see if they go for a similar lineup this time around, as the Earth Spirit Lashrak is pickoff for the beginning, at least with the Earth Spirit.
Radiant.
So in this series of two, it is Alliance 1, Mega-Lada 0. Lifestealer banned out, Lina banned out by Alliance. So we'll see what they want to go for Mega-Lada. Of course, they already have that Warlock, so that's a bit of team fight for them. Naga Siren still in the pool.
10 seconds remaining.
You know, they could do a little bit of what Alliance did in the last game and pick up that Naga Siren. Did we hear a song last game? Now that I think about it, like,
Dire team
I don't
pick.
Remember Sky a song made. In the last game. Yeah, I don't remember it. But Skywrath Mage picked up for Mega-Lada, which I think pushes Warlock into the 4. Gonna be getting more farm than Skywrath, but I'm not too certain. I mean, Warlock could certainly sit in the 5. Skywrath could sit
remaining.
In the 4. Maybe get himself my favorite item on Skywrath. Ags.
5 seconds remaining.
So we'll see. We'll see what Alliance want to do.
Radiant
coming up
pick.
With this next pick is they do pick up Razor. So Razor picked up. Razor, Earth Spirit, Lashrak. That Razor's going to be in the mid lane, but we've seen it safe lane plenty of times, so I wouldn't be shocked there either.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
It does probably come down to where the matchup's going to be. So, it's again, it's interesting to see Alliance without Loda. They had Peksu in the last game, and he did well. I mean, I liked his play. We'll see if Insignia, Boxy, and Tega can make this change and, you know, replace Peksu well enough. Yes, we're looking for this fourth pick for Mega-Lada with the Skywrath Mage, Warlock, Axe. Again, they've got that initiation with the Axe, and I do like the Blink Call Chaotic Offering. So, and not even that, the Blink Call Skywrath Mage. I think that's a solid combination as well. So, we'll have to see, you know, which way they do want to end up taking this in terms of who's going to be the 4, who's going to be the 5.
Dire team pick.
And they go to the Luna, so Luna picked up, team fight oriented again with that Eclipse, pushing capabilities with the Glaives. I mean, with the Skywrath, the chase is for sure on, I'd say. Skywrath Luna, Lucent Beam, you've got the slow, the concussive shot of Skywrath Mage. You can definitely give a chase.
5 seconds remaining.
Also, is the sound... I mean, obviously you can't tell with the draft. It's not really in-game sound at the moment. But I did try to switch up the sound a little bit. I gotta fix it. My sound system internal mixer program is kind of messed up at the moment. So I'm trying to figure all that out. And I'll probably have to fix that all during my off time after this. So fourth pick from Alliance... Razor, Earth Spirit, Lushrak. I think that throws a little Shrak into the 5. And Darkseer in the offlane. Which, I mean, the combination here with Alliance is kind of nice. Split Earth from Lushrak with the Vacuum or the Boulder Smash that can land on multiple heroes. As long as you can keep them close, Razor takes that damage, throws it back at Mega-Lada. I like that combination. I like the Darkseer Vacuum Wall. I like the Ion Shell on a couple of these heroes. I actually kind of like it when you throw the Ion Shell onto the Earth Spirit, he's rolling boulders in, has the boulder smash. I mean, he's staying so close that the Ion Shell is doing a lot of damage. And I do like that combination of the Darkseer, Earth Spirit, especially aggressive early. You can definitely work with that Darkseer, usually using the Ion Shells to farm up.
5 seconds remaining.
You know, you want to have one... in his escape. So Darkseer, Razor, Earth Spirit, Lushrak. They ban out the Viper. Earth Spirit gets banned out by Mega-Lada. I think they believe that that Razor is in the safe lane. I wouldn't be too shocked at that either. We've seen Razor mid. We've seen Razor safe lane. I do like it safe lane. It's going to be up against the Axe, which I don't think should give Razor that much of a problem. But, you know, if the Axe remaining. Later in the game does get that Blade Mail, you got to be careful as that Razor, especially stealing that damage and throwing it back
Five
on them.
Seconds remaining.
You know, you're going to be probably getting a BKB at some point. Maybe sometime
Radiant
quite early.
Pick.
Last pick comes out from Alliance. It's going to be Jakiro. So, yeah, I think that throws Lushrak into the core role. Lushrak mid, Razor safe lane, Darkseer off lane, Earth Spirit 4, Jakiro 5. So they do go to the Lushrak in the core position.
Tinker
picked up by Mega-Lada. Yeah, Mickey on the Lushrak. This is going to be a show. This should be interesting. Let's take a look. You've got Stormcat on the Tinker, Czar on the Luna, Skywrath Mage, Eknar, Muriel Warlock, Funic back on that Axe, and we saw him get a Vanguard very quickly in that first game. We'll see if he's going to be able to pull that off again. And Sanya, he's back in onto the team for this game two instead of Pexu on the Jakiro in the position five. Boxy is the Darkseer in that three spot in the offlane. You've got a little Shrek play by Mickey. And that leaves Tega with the Earth Spirit and Razor played by Quikva. So we'll see if the in-game sound is a little bit too low for you guys.
Prepare for battle.
Just let me know. I'll fix it. Maybe not this game, but I've got a whole season to work on it. Especially just once I fix my internal sound program, it'll probably be a lot better. It has unfortunately reset itself. So mid ward placed out here by Muriel on this Warlock. With this new collector cache set, looking nice, getting the nice rare set going for himself. And let's see, Mickey, at least for now, sitting near the offlane. I mean, Boxy should be here, Mickey should be moving over mid eventually, but maybe they want to try and get for themselves first blood. Muriel here with Stormcat and Czar. Muriel with the Shadow Word, so this is going to be a tough one if they do in fact try to go. And we saw it last time with Funic, who was able to get a lot of damage out onto Alliance, but just wasn't able to get the kill. Pexu put the Shadow Word onto Quikva, and Quikva was able to withstand the nice harassment from Mega-Lada early, so that could really change the game. They ended up getting the Sven first blood over bottom anyway, so it didn't quite matter.
The battle begins.
So it looks like Alliance are going to grab three Bounty Runes. Battle Hunger comes out on Quikva, he gets harassed again early on, but this time only one stack of tangos and a salve, so. See how he plays this out, especially when Eknard's going to be able to harass this Alliance side quite a bit. You've got Mickey against Stormcat. Stormcat, we'll see how this lane goes for him. I think Mickey might have a good time here up against this Tinker if he's got himself possibly a rotation coming out from Taiga eventually. And, Taiga is a very aggressive Earth Spirit, so I wouldn't quite be surprised. Boxy, meanwhile, pulling these creeps. Just level one for now. Has the Ion Shell, of course. And this is a dual lane for both the off and safe lane for both teams again. As Skywrath Mage getting very low. And Senya just trying to really pressure him. After he's trying to pull this lane and does successfully do so. As he's going to be throwing that Arcane Bolt at Insania constantly if he's going to get nearby this pull. And the pull is to help out Funic, try and get him that farm, try and get him those levels. Again, looking for that quick Vanguard once again that he was able to successfully get last time. So they put the Iron Shell into the Earth Spirit. It's got Rolling Boulder. That's going to miss. Doesn't have the Boulder Smash to follow it up, but the harassment will come out on Czar. The Shadow Word to heal him up. Tega a little bit too deep here, but won't really get got on as the chase. So once that Lucent Beam is up, there is not much of it. So you're going to need that Boulder Smash, you're going to need that level 2. Once you have the level 2, you land the Rolling Boulder as well as the Boulder Smash, and you should be able to get yourself a kill over in this lane, especially with the Ion Shell. Maybe when it gets to level 2, it will get that much easier. But maybe you give him the Ion Shell and he moves over towards mid. That wouldn't be too shocking either, but he is level 2, and now we'll see him with the Haste most likely go over towards mid. Stormcat hit with the Rolling Boulder, has the Boulder Smash, and there's the Split Earth. That's going to land. That's going to be first blood for Mickey as the help comes out from Tega, and it's with that Haste rune that he's able to make a play at this mid lane. And Alliance, they take out the Tinker early. Stormcat just unable to really find an escape there, and that's honestly no surprise once you get hit with that Rolling Boulder as well as the Boulder Smash. The Lightning Storm comes out, the Split Earth comes through. There's just nowhere you can really go, and they're set up for it again. He's got himself mana for one, for both, actually. So, yeah, rolling boulder, boulder smash, split earth, and now they've got the lightning storm. They'll get themselves a second kill consecutively over mid. So, Mickey and Tega just giving a wallop to this Tinker. And that's exactly what I said was going to happen. I mean, you play it very aggressive with the Earth Spirit. Tega, I've seen this before. I wouldn't be surprised to see him just go off and be the MVP of this game. He is so good on this hero. Doesn't even need the Ion Shell to make anything happen, but now he's found an Ekknart! So the Rolling Boulder comes in, Tega gets the kill, and it's 3-0 Alliance, a 1,000 net worth lead. This is the Earth Spirit kind of game you're going to want to see, and I know I'm kind of fanboying over Tega, and I'm cooling myself off as I fanboy so much, but I'm just impressed with the play. Impressive Dota play, always exciting. Come on, dude. Even steals that Invis rune from Uriel, gets the Rolling Boulder in to do so. Boxy coming around, they do have the vision on him. But they will back off, and it will be Tega coming over towards mid once again, because Insania is harassing Ekknart. They'll have the Lightning Storm. They can land the Split Earth, they'll get the kill. The slow comes out onto Insania, but with Lightning Storm, they'll clean him up. Tega's here in Viz under Stormcat, so he doesn't even need to Rolling Boulder in. The Boulder Smash, that's going to push him back. Marching the Machines from Stormcat, but now the Rolling Boulder comes through. They've got Mickey ready to just harass Stormcat, and it's a double kill for Mickey. Tega all over the map. He's 1-0-3, 4 of the 5, 80% kill involved, and just looking good is this Alliance side early.
Ooh. It is mine.
So it's a 1,000 net worth lead, and really looking good, at least for right now, as Alliance is Funnic with the Battle Hunger. Arcane Bolt, there's the call, will land. Funnic now thinking about just TPing out, but Quickf is here. He's got the Static Link, he's got the damage. Insania gonna survive as the Plasma Field comes out and gets the kill. Meanwhile, Mickey comes over, cleans up Ekknart, both die, and it's 7-0 in favor of Alliance. But over bottom, the fight rages on. The Geomagnetic Grip silence up to these heroes. Tega finally drops to Ekknart, who comes on over with a TP. Boxy will attempt to TP out under this tier 1 tower, and will do so. They kill off Czar, 8-1. And Alliance aggressive all over. Already a 2,000 net worth lead. Very different from game one, where they were down about 3,000-4,000 for the first 10 minutes or so. They sat back a little bit more. This time they've got an Earth Spirit. They've got a hero that can really help them be aggressive. And Tig is doing exactly that, to move around this map so efficiently to really make plays on this Mega-Lada squad that just maybe aren't expecting this kind of aggression. It's Tega Earth Spirit. You really should just be ready to know that this is coming. Now you've got the Ion Shell. The smoke comes out from Insania. And they're going to come around again. And already, to me, Czar's a little bit too far forward. He's only level 5. Rolling Boulder comes out. Actually blocked by Ekknart smartly. Nicely done there to block him, but it's not going to keep Czar alive. They'll get the kill. They look for Boxy, but they don't have the damage. And they lose both as Mickey's made his way over. Wisely, not smartly. Smartly not a word. N-A vocab. For ya. But 10-1. Two kills there again. They took out the Luna one more time. And Alliance, again, just steamrolling this Mega-Lada team. Actually, they found Insania. Vanguard picked up 7 minutes in for Funnic. Czar does get the kill.
Not your best.
What was that worth them? Not too much. 300 gold. Not bad, though. Tega. He'll be taking what he can over mid. Mickey. He's already level 8. Very ahead of this Tinker. Boxy's level 6. 3 into the surge, 3 into the ion shell. He's looking quite good right now. And Koikfa too. I mean, he's got treads, he's going for the drums, just trying to keep that speed.
Not on my watch.
So let's see what Alliance do as they come over bottom. Boxy will show himself. The tower hits him. Arcane Bolt getting thrown. They've got Muro as well as Czar down here. Pull this creep waving with the ion shell. Just able to really clean it up and clean up these creeps as well. So efficiency is the name of the game right now from Alliance. And hello, Eknart. There's the Boulder Smash. Usopp comes out on a Tega. They do have this Eclipse to work with. And there it is. And there it goes. Tega, well, I wanted to say he was out, but Arcane Bolt, Fatal Bonds, and shoot, Geomagnetic Grip. But that's not going to keep him alive. Elastic comes out from Czar. Mickey gets the kill over Min, and now he's rotating over. They want to go in onto this Mega-Lada side as they've got Koikfa coming through. There's the nice ice path with the split earth. They'll take out Czar. They'll look for more. Muriel will be the next one to fall. Three dead on Mega-Lada. An Alliance, yes, they lose Tega, but they take plenty in return. And it's a 3,000 net worth lead. Well, Alliance in. Hello, Eknart. Goodbye, Eknart.
You can't escape the underscape.
Get another kill, and they continue to extend this lead. Switch it over to the net worth about 10 minutes in. Take a look. Mickey here, top of the net worth. Going for the Yules as Concussive Shot comes out, as well as the Battle Hunger. Split Earth lands. Arcane Bolt one more time.
What have
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Meanwhile, over top, Tega. Owing Boulder grabs the both bounty runes. Come on. They also grab all four total, but Tega
Radiant
just
structures are
all over the place, grabbing anything and everything
Radiant's
he can.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Muriel, far forward, but Tega knows that
Radiant's bottom
there's a little bit more coming
attack.
With him, and he cannot go after
Radiant's
this Warlock just yet. Meanwhile,
fallen.
Over bottom, Koikfa gets the kill onto this Tier 1 tower, finishes off the drums, has 1,000 gold on top of that. Boxy's here, Rolling Boulder, Geomagnetic Grip doesn't land the Rolling Boulder just yet. Silence is up, Eknar, now he's got that seal to come through on a Tega. There's the vacuum into this Centaur. And that is the work of the vacuum with the Helm of the Dominator. You have that stun at the ready with the vacuum. They'll get the kill. Meanwhile, Muriel also drops. As Mickey made his way over, and they get two kills over top again. So 16-3. Alliance up so much already. Top three of the net worth here. All three of their cores up by so much as you take a look at what Stormcat has, and he's going for the Boots of Travel. He's 400 gold away from that, but his farm is just so scarce right now. He can't really find anything, and ooh, Eknart going to be spotted. Boulder Smash, Split Earth, gone you are. And there's the Lightning Storm. Mickey now godlike at 9-0-4 on this little Shrek. And this all comes off the pressure that Tega put in early. He was able to rotate over towards me, get two consecutive kills on the Tinker, give himself a hard lane. Boulder Smash is actually going to miss with the Rolling Boulder. There's the Eclipse, but it's not going to do enough damage as the creeps are here. Or not the creeps, the two other heroes are here to mitigate the damage of the Eclipse. The creeps were from the side of the Radiant, and they do kill off Czar again, continuing to shut down the cores of the Mega-Lada team. So Funnet gonna try and go for this. Blink into the jungle is both Tega and Insania. Oh, they find Stormcat, Boulder Smash lands, and there's the Geomagnetic Grip with the Ice Path magnetized. See ya. Stormcat, see ya. We get another kill now, 3-19. Oh boy, Eknart. He's gonna fall. He gets chased by this Dark Troll Summoner with the Ion Shell on him. He ends up dying. It's 3-20 as they kill off just this Skywrath as well as the Tinker. They killed the Luna over top.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
The dream is close. They are 8,000 net worth ahead. Mickey just continuing to push over bottom. Level 11 has the Yules, has the Arcane Boots going into the Bloodstone. The rotation comes out from Insania Tega as well as Koikva. They TP in. They've got the Rockets. There's the Rolling Boulder. Boulder Smash comes out. The Geomagnetic Grip's going to follow that up. They should be able to get the kill on the Eknard. He will fall. The Ice Path lands onto the Chaotic Offering. Comes down. Is it going to break the dream? They've got the Battle Hunger coming through as well as the Rockets. Can we find it, please? The Vacuum. The Coin Blade's not going to be enough. It's 4-22. They'll take out Tega. Muriel will fall. Quakefoot drops as well, but they end up killing off Czar. Here comes Mickey. Boxy and Zanya are all here to kill off Bunning. Mickey drops really low. Dives to the laser of Stormcat. And Alliance actually lose 4 in that exchange. A lot of gold going over to Mega-Lada as they killed off Mickey, killing off that 10-0 spree. And actually, Stormcat's here with the blink as well as the boots of travel. All of a sudden, he's topping the net worth by 700 gold. So this Tinker all of a sudden is looking really strong. And that was, what, a 3,000 net worth chunk taken out from Alliance's lead? This game severely turns around with that.
Invisibility.
So despite it being 24-8, I kind of want to say Alliance need to finish this soon. They need to pressure, they need to push, they need to make sure this Tinker can't find any more farm. That's going to be tough. I mean, he's got Boots of Travel as well as the Blink ready to go. And when he's got enough vision, I mean, we know the dangerous combo with a Bounty Hunter Tinker. So, like, of course you've got that vision. But when you get vision here without the Bounty Hunter, I mean, it's just going to be brutal to Alliance with these rockets and lasers coming out. So Alliance, let's see what they do, because they really need to adapt and change their game plan here.
Radiant's top tower
as,
is under attack.
I do think Mega-Lada are kind of hitting a nice strong spot with Stormcat, and if he can open up the map for the rest of the team, you get Luna, this Dragonlance, as well as the BKB. Maybe we see Mega-Lada get back in because they've got the Axe with the Blink Dagger and the Vanguard, so they're looking ready to be aggressive, ready to fight. Here comes this Tinker, and Funnick doesn't have the blink. There's going to be the Static Link on him. The Ice Path lands on two. Insania lands on nice Static Link. The Splitters comes in. Funnick drops. Tega on the back end is going to fall. Vacuum into the wall. Now they're trying to run away. They've already lost two. Czar trying to get out of town, but the Plasma Field comes in. They'll take out three. They'll take out four. They'll look for the full team wipe as they kill off Stormcat. Ultra kill for Koikva. An Alliance. They show just what they're made of, and Mega-Lada feeling themselves after that last exchange. But it turns poor as Alliance. They take out the whole side of Mega-Lada, and the push is on.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
So, 9-29, back to a 10,000 net worth lead. They grab this tier 2 over bottom. And things slow down for Mega-Lada all of a sudden. Back to top of the net worth is Koikva, picking up that BKB and for the Blink Dagger. Next, they take a look at the Darkseer. He's got that hood as well as the Helm of the Dominator. Just continue to farm with the Ion Shell. Concussive Shot comes out. But he's safe here with the Jakiro, or at least should be. Take a looking for the Blink Dagger. I keep seeing Tega. I know it's Taiga. But for some reason, that's stuck in my head, and I apologize. So, look at Tinker's farm, and he's got that Aether Lens. Going for the Dagon play. Again, Dragonlance next here for Czar. And then Funnick. Blink. He's got the Vanguard. So, see what they're able to do on the side of Mega-Lada. The fights just have to be placed well. They just, you know, maybe they need to sit back a little bit more, not be so aggressive, and farm up. Because Czar needs the farm. He needs to get this BKB. I think if he sits back, they get this farm onto this Luna, I think they're off in a better spot. And they almost feel like they're forced to fight. But the push isn't really too heavy from Alliance. You know, they're not pushing as aggressively as we saw. Yes, they took the tier 2 down over bottom. They're down to tier 2s over top and mid. But you're able to really push that out with the Tinker. As long as he stays alive, gets the march through, keeps these lanes sustained, that should help Czar find some farm. He's got the Dragon Lance now. And I mean, that's really, if Mega-Lada just sit back and farm on the Luna, they should be okay. Over mid, Blink Call, Mystic Flare, as well as the Culling Blade. We'll take out the Jakiro and Senya. And they get a nice kill. Little boost of gold there for Funic. So yeah, Tinker looking like he's gonna go for the Dagon. Blink Dagger picked up by Taiga. Up towards top. They've got Mickey Taiga as well as Koikva.
Radiant are scanning.
Scans come out from both teams.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Gold is a great conductor.
Ariel,
what is he? Level 8, so only has level 1 on the golem. Not too bad.
What surge is this?
And again, just sustaining right now is Alliance. Going for the Blink Dagger on Boxy. Has the pipe. Has the hood, Helm of the Dominator.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Is it Blade Mail next for... Yeah, okay. Blade Mail next.
Structures are fortified.
Makes sense.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Dire lose that mid-tier one. And over top, Funic is looking to maybe get a blink in there and find a nice call, as they are posturing for the side of Alliance over top.
Radiant's
dead here with the march, just trying to continue to push it out. 4 heroes still posturing for Alliance. As they bring in the fifth Boxy, but they kind of back out. So 8,000.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And worth lead in. They're still a little bit scared of going in, rightfully so. We saw the last fight over there towards that top bounty rune for the Radiant side. Just go poorly. And Mega-Lada, though, they're finding some space and time to farm. And I don't know if you want to be able to give up this BKB to Czar. If you're Alliance, you're going to get the BKB. Blade Mail comes out next for Axe. If he's able to pull that off, as well as get these levels onto the Dagon for Tinker. Nice blink. Boulder Smash, as well as the Magnetize. Vacuum Wall comes out. They'll kill off Eknard as well as Stormcat all of a sudden. And Alliance, clean up too. They clean up the Tinker. And with the Tinker gone, you gotta think Alliance either go for Roche or push. And I would assume they go for the push, especially with the Diabolic Edict just chunking out these towers. Meanwhile, Boxy goes down to Funic. That's gonna be over in the jungle. Boxy dead for 47, but those 2 heroes here, while the tier 2 over mid is, in fact, going to fall. And with that, maybe they back off to Roche. But with them pressuring over towards the bottom tier 1, the TPs will come out. The Geomagnetic Rip, as well as the Boulder Smash, that's going to come through on a Czar. Got the Static Link, but Koikva forced pop that BKB. They'll get the kill onto the Luna. They look over at Funic with the Yules, as well as the Split Earth. Funic locked in, killed off. Boulder Smash comes out from this Earth Spirit, and it's a double kill for Koikva. They clean up 2 more on the side of Mega-Lada.
I
gets the kill by the shrine. Senya staying a little bit too close. So pipe on the Jakiro, pipe on the Darkseer. 18 charges for Lashrak. McKee on this. Lashrak has only died once when 10-0 to start. And then he died. But then he picked up the Bloodstone and now he's got himself another kill. He's farming very well. Just staying all right up there with the Razor as well as the Tinker as they do smoke up. BKB on cooldown for another 8 seconds. Zeknart. Spotted. Blink actually forward. As well as the Rolling Boulder to attempt to maybe go for that kill onto the Skywrath Mage, but it won't go any further. So let's see, Boxy going for the mech. Rules here on the Earth Spirit, Koifa, Sanjin Yasha. Tinker with the Dagon level 2. Luna has picked up the BKB. That is a 10-second BKB ready to go. Hurricane Pike next into the Butterfly for this Luna. And they do smoke up. They look over towards bottom. There are heroes nearby, but nobody too close. And Jakiro scan, blink, call, Mystic Flare dead. Eknar gets the kill. Coin Blade actually a little bit too early. So yeah, they kill off the Jakiro. That's a smoke used for that. The push will be on from Mega-Lada.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And Alliance, they're going to set up for this. They lose the tier 1. Let's see if the push stays from Mega-Lada. They think about it for a moment. And they back off, they TP out.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Dagon level 3 here for Stormcat. So they've been able to move around this map pretty well. I know they got cleaned up over bottom, but in terms of net worth, they're okay on the Tinker and the Luna. The big fall off is, of course, the Funic, and their two supports just really not having much farm, which isn't the worst thing in the world when you just need Warlock to have levels. Skywrath, I mean, you'd like him to have farm. He's got himself the Veil. What more are you really asking for from a Skywrath Mage? In terms of supports, from Alliance, ooh, Blink, Boulder Smash, onto the Luna, Geomagnetic Ripple, Split Earth, Lightning Storm, Ice Path, Czar, queened up. It's dead for 60 seconds, so Alliance, they find Luna again. And they go over towards Roche. Compare that to the farm at Jakiro. He's got the pipe. You've got the Earth Spirit with the Blink as well as the Urn going into the Yules. I mean, these supports are farmed on Alliance. Makes up most of the difference, as well as obviously the difference in offlane and Funic. Like I said, is struggling a little bit in terms of farm. So they take the Roche. Aegis picked up on Mickey. Going for the Boots of Travel. He'll try to rotate all over the map, continuing to push with the Pulse Nova as well as the Diabolic Edict.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
There's a Force Staff, and there's the Hurricane Pike. So, Butterfly Axe for Luna. Okay. Our Spirit taken out. Funic gets the kill. That's nice, as he definitely needs these kills. Only 3 total in this game. 3, 4, and 3. He's got that Blade Mail, but his farm is slowed down immensely. And BKB pop by Czar. That's the 10-second. Yeah, that's 10-second BKB. And now that knowing that BKB is no longer there, They're gonna try and come over. Mickey gets spotted by this ward. So they do have vision. It finally times out. But, I mean, that's 10 second BKB used defensively, and I would say kind of a huge waste. So let's see. I want to see if Mega-Lada can pull this back. It definitely seems like they're playing around Alliance enough and finding kills where they can get them. Again, they need Funnic to find a little bit more farm. Tinker working with the Dagon level 3 and is actually going to stop going for the Dagon levels and go for the Hex. So Sheepstick next. Luna, like we saw, is going for the Butterfly. Ooh. Funnic gets the kill on Boxy. Now the return comes out from Alliance. They've got the Splitter with as well as the Ice Path. Yeah, the call is there for you, Funnic, but you're not going to be able to survive the damage that's coming through. So it's a trade for offlaners, which ends up with net worth going the way of Mega-Lada. And I guess Funnic's not the worst hero to lose with where his net worth is. He'll be back up before the Darkseer around the same time, honestly. But again, this is opening up the map for Stormcat to farm. He wants that Hex as well as the Luna. Get that Butterfly and... You know, you're starting to really get that net worth up. You only have 3 kills, 8 deaths on Czar. And somehow, still relatively close to Koikva in terms of farm.
What have we here?
The concussive shot comes out. But again, Alliance playing this very slow. They've got the Aegis, got the BKB on Lashrak, 10 second BKB.
What surge is this?
The 9 second BKB on Koikva, and actually, okay. Skips the Hex, skips the Sheepstick, goes straight to the Dagon 5. Different plan, and uh-oh, Muriel in a little bit of trouble. The Plasma Field comes out. Mickey's here with the Lightning Storm, and there it is. Dominating again is Mickey. As he's now found himself 14-1-8, 21 Bloodstone charges. Meanwhile, over towards top is Czar. Little TP in Mickey, and I think they're rotating around the back, and there it is. The Earth Spear, Boulder Smash, Geomagnetic Grip. The BKB is going to be popped as well as the Eclipse. They try to turn it around. They'll get the kill onto this Earth Spear, but now you got to run. Or maybe you don't, because Stormcat's here. The Blink, the Call. Egnar comes through with a Mystic Flare. They've taken out this Aegis, and now on the back lines is Boxy as well as Koikva as they've got themselves the vacuum into the wall. They'll kill up this Tinker. They'll look for more. Funnic trying to run away. Let's see if they can get the kill onto the tier 3 tower. The call comes out. The counter helixes are not enough as the Ice Path comes through. 4 dead on the side of Mega-Lada. And they'll lose the tier 2 over top. And the push is on to the tier 3 as well. Buyback comes out from Egnar. Funnic has it as well. He's going to use his. And now it's 4v4. Looking to maybe defend this top tier 3. Blink call. Going to miss. Now used up. Ice Path there waiting. Boxy. Split Earth, he's still stunned up. The Lucent Beam comes out from Czar. They're waiting 37 seconds for this Tinker. Mickey will TP over towards bottom to pressure elsewhere. So Alliance continuing to just extend this lead, and they take a nice fight. They force out the Eclipse. The BKB comes out as well from Czar. Yeah, he gets a kill onto the Earth Spirit, but honestly, not worth the price of a BKB. Meanwhile, Aeon Disc picked up for the Lashrak. 16-1-8, Mickey just going off. Looking really good this game. 24 Bloodstone charges, working on getting to level 24. 25, he'll probably take the Diabolic Edict Explosions to take the high ground. Butterfly is finished for the Luna. And next, I mean, the Ags is queued up, but maybe it's the Satanic next. Bofa. Tiger. Nobody coming in just yet. Four heroes up towards top for Alliance, and again, Mickey just continuing to be all over the map, pushing Radiant out, farming up as much as he can. Scan comes out for the rainy. It will spot four heroes. Obviously, they don't know that. They just have a scan check. And you've got the AoE surge, which is really nice in terms of speed to help Koifa stay through with a static link. As well as the Eye of the Storm. I mean, the AoE on Surge is just absolutely disgusting. So they are smoked up. Blink, call, Mystic Flare. They'll take up the Earth Spirit. Now they look at the Arcane Bolt. The blink on forward from Koifa with the BKB. Chaotic Offering, that'll get dropped. Not really doing that much of a good job as the Eclipse comes through, but it's not really doing enough. They'll lose themselves. This Skywrath Mage, they look over at Czar. He's trying to keep himself alive, but the Aeon, this is going to be popped on Mickey. They've got themselves three. They've only lost the Earth Spirit so far. Mickey looking over at Funic. Funic all by himself. Now Koifa comes over with the Blade Mail, but it's not going to be enough as the call comes through, but it's not finding itself a home. There's no Coing Blade to be had, and four die on the side of Mega-Lada. Yes, Tinker survives, but Stormcat all by himself, and Alliance will heal up.
Gold is a great conductor.
So Butterfly next for Koikva. Mickey with the Shiva's next. That Aeon Disc proving to work wonders, and 28 charges on the Bloodstone. I mean, that's nice. Butterfly finished here for Koifa, and then, of course, Earth Spirit going for the Yule still, and Jakiro with the Glimmer Cape as well as the Pipe. And then Darkseer. He's got the Lotus Orb and going into the Guardian Greaves. So the Sustain is out for Alliance. The Chase is on with the AoE Surge. They have so many tools at their disposal. And Alliance, you know, with a 22,000 net worth lead, 43-17. We'll see how Alliance look to finish off this game. Magnetized action comes out. There's a concussive shot. The Lucent Beam in trouble is going to be this Earth Spirit. Will find himself dead. Another BKB's pop by Koifa. Looks over at Czar. He's going to try and TP out. Mickey is going to find the Split Earth. Gets the kill on Eknard as well as Muriel. That finds, is this Tinker just trying to blink away? And they lose two. They take out the Earth Spirit, but that's about it. So again, Alliance just sitting here with the 23,000, 24,000 net worth lead, continuing to just win these exchanges. Comes at the cost of the Earth Spirit's life, but not really the biggest casualty in these fights, especially when they're able to take out cores. Of course, they took out the Skywrath as well as the Warlock, and Luna was able to TP out in that last fight using the BKB, immediately TPing out. Going for the Divine Rapier next, Satanic. We'll see what he goes for first. As Alliance, they come over to grab this Roche. Aegis and Cheese, second Roche of the game. There's really nowhere that Mega-Lada can go with this. They're just kind of afraid to push out, and there's, you know, full reason to be that scared. As Alliance, they haven't really lost a fight since the exchange over by the top shrine for the Radiant. And that was, what, 20 minutes ago? 25 minutes ago? So 30 Bloodstone charges. Lushrak Mickey has one of the best games I've seen on Lushrak. Or having one of the best games I've seen on Lushrak. And I do think it all stems from the Earth Spirit, who was able to make those rotations very early. And they found themselves Stormcat, gone for 80 seconds, and just found out in no man's land in that jungle as Alliance are able to get that kill. He's dead for 80 seconds with no buyback. So now the push is onto the tier 3. There's the blink with the call. Pops the Aeon Disco Mickey. Blinkfoot taking a little bit of damage, has the Battle Hunger on him. Arcane Bolts coming through the vacuum into the ice path with the split earth, and that's going to take out Muriel as well as Czar. He's forced to buy him back. They look over at Eknar. Quickly gets the kill. Funnick with the Magnetize on him. Can't blink into this fight. The tier 3 is gone. The buyback from Luna 2v5 right now in their base. Mid-set Arax will go down. And Alliance will head over towards bottom. Yules through on a Funnick. Split earth. Blade mail just not doing anything for you. An axe. He'll fall and immediately buy back. Czar, really all he can do is watch. Use the tier 4s and now over to the Ancient. The blink, the attempt, the ice path comes through as well as the Yule's BKB pop by Czar. They try to make something happen, but there's the vacuum. They'll lose the axe and they'll lose the Luna. Everybody dead on the side of Mega-Lada. And this will be the second game. It's going to be a 2-0 series for Alliance. So, a lot cleaner that second game from Alliance. Don't think we'll have the stats because of the coordinator. Let's see. We don't. Okay. I guess not. So that's fun. But no stats there. Nothing for us to work with. And Alliance making it look real nice. So they take the series 2-0. That's it for me today. That's the only series here in the EU for the Premier League of joinDOTA Season 13. My apologies go out to Alliance, Mickey, and Lota for saying the name wrong. But thank you guys so much for joining me in this series of two. And I'll be back another day. Thank you for watching on joinDOTA Blue. And yeah, I guess that's it. Thank you so much. And I'm your caster, BCOP, at BCOP92 on Twitter. Follow me there to know when I'm casting. And again, we'll see you later.